Aye.
The boy that was speaking is Flynn Rider. Rapunzel is the girl here, and she is the main character in this movie. She lives in a tower. Do you have any idea why? She lives in a tower because her mother doesn't want to let her go. Flynn Rider is running from a person. He sees this tower and he climbs up. And that's when Rapunzel hits him with a frying pan.
How you doing? The name's Flynn Rider. How's your day going? Huh?
Who else knows my location, Flynn Rider?
All right, Blondie.
Rapunzel.
Do you see that golden thing around Flynn Rider? That is actually Rapunzel's hair. It is so long, it can wrap someone around. Many times, actually.
Gesundheit, here's the deal. I was in a situation, gallivanting through the forest. I came across your tower, and where is my satchel?
I've hidden it.
Look at Rapunzel. She looks really triumphant. If you look triumphant, it means you look like you won something. Now, look at Flynn's face. Do you think he's impressed? I think not.
Somewhere you'll never find it.
It's in that pot, isn't it?
Oh, shoot! Another hit from Rapunzel! He must hit hard because it looks like Flynn kind of blacked out.
Would you stop that?
Welcome to another video lesson where you will master English vocabulary, practice grammar, and improve your pronunciation through great movies, series, and YouTube videos. I'm your teacher, Burak Senel, and seeing you today made my day. In this Learn English with Movies video, we're going to watch a scene from Tangled. Tangled takes the story of Rapunzel and turns it into an adorable animation movie. You gotta give it to Disney because Disney knows how to make animation movies. Go ahead and subscribe to Loom now and click the bell button next to the subscribe button if you want to improve your English while having fun. Now, let's go and hit Flynn's hat together.
Hi.
How you doing? The name's Flynn Rider.
There are many different ways to introduce yourself in English. When you say the names followed by your name, you introduce yourself in a cool way. Many non-native speakers use "my name is" to introduce themselves. But it's not really that common to introduce yourself with that phrase in English. A common way people will introduce themselves in the United States is by saying "I'm" followed by their name. For example, "I'm John." If you have a preferred name that you want people to call you, you can say, "I go by the name of... I'm John, but I go by the name of JJ." You can also use the word "name" as a verb. If you name something, you simply give it a name. You can name your child or your cat. In the scene, Flynn introduces himself as...
The name's Flynn Rider.
Because it is a cool way to introduce yourself. He wants to look cool.
The name's Flynn Rider. How's your day going, huh?
Who else knows my location, Flynn Rider?
All right, Blondie.
Rapunzel.
Gesundheit.
A German word in English, Gesundheit, literally means health. This word is used when someone sneezes. By saying Gesundheit, you wish them good health. It has the same meaning as bless you. English is one of the few languages where you wish good health to someone that sneezes. There is an idiom that has the word sneeze in it. That's nothing to sneeze at. If something makes you sneeze, you probably want to keep away from it, right? If something is nothing to sneeze at, then you don't want to run away from it. That thing must be important. If your friend tells you, "My nose has been bleeding for 2 days," you can say, "That's nothing to sneeze at. You should see a doctor." Back to sneezing. When Rapunzel says her name, Flynn says
Gesundheit,
making fun of Rapunzel's name, because he pretends that the name Rapunzel sounds like someone sneezing. Do you agree with him?
Gesundheit. Here's the deal. I was in a situation, gallivanting through the forest.
The word gallivant means to travel without an aim, just for the fun of it. Let's say you finished high school and you don't want to go to university directly. You can take a year off to gallivant around your city, country, or even abroad. When Flynn says
gallivanting through the forest,
he means he was just riding his horse for fun in the forest. The opposite of to gallivant would be to go directly to somewhere without wasting time.
I was in a situation, gallivanting through the forest. I came across a tower and where is my satchel?
A satchel is a small bag with a shoulder strap. It is generally used for carrying books or clothing. This is called a strap, and it helps you carry the bag more easily. Did you know that the word satchel shares the same root with the word sack? You can see a photo of a sack here. Compare the photo of a satchel and the photo of a sack. Why do you think they share the same root? What is the common thing between them? Let me know in the comments.
Where is my satchel?
I've hidden it. Somewhere you'll never find it.
It's in that pot, isn't it? You stop that!
Instead of saying stop that, Flynn says
you stop that?
You probably know will as an auxiliary verb for the future simple tense. But did you know that it can also be used to request something from someone? Here are some examples. Will you close the window, please? Will you come with me to the theatre? Will you write that down for me? This is way politer than just saying, "Write that down for me." I'll show you a way to make requests even more politely. Simply replace the word will with would. Would you close the window, please? Would you come with me to the theatre? Would you write that down for me? You would generally use would to ask something from someone that you don't know. Try this next time you ask something from someone.
You stop that?
Hi. How you doing?
The name's Flynn, right?
How's your day going, huh?
Who else knows my location, Flynn Rider?
All right, Blondie.
Rapunzel.
Gesundheit. Here's the deal. I was in a situation. Gallivanting. I came across your tower and where is my satchel?
I've hidden it. Somewhere you'll never find it.
It's in that pot, isn't it?
Sheesh! Great job! You collected all the stars and I see you were great with the questions. If you want to improve your English, make sure to subscribe and follow us on our social media accounts. Thanks for being with me in another video. Can't wait to see you in the next one. Take care and bloom now.